Welcome back. We've had two races down and we've got one to go. The men's pursuit will be on very shortly, but just a little bit of track work to be done just to get that ready for the men's pursuit. The women's 3,000 metres, Nana Takahashi taking gold for Japan. Very good performance, but let's take a look back at the men's 1,500. Ready. All about speed in this one. And Adrian Avioga, with a bit of experience from the last championships, very good performer across a number of distances. The Polish athlete in the red speed suit on the inside part of this track for his start. And at this point in time, very good skate from the Austrian Armin Hager to record a time of 1:54.00, but then that was surpassed by Marcin Baczynek of Poland. 1:52.56 set by Wilgat's Polish compatriot. So that was the time that he was skating at this point. And the Japanese skater in the darker of the speed suits was also turning in a good performance, but Tsuchiya with a little stumble cost him really everything in this race, and boy did he fight hard during the closing stages. So hitting the bell with 400 to go. Yuga with an advantage of just 0.08 of a second over his compatriot, Baczynek. Very good work from Tsuchiya, because he really had no right to be in this position as they hit the closing straight. But he did very well to recover, but unfortunately in the end it cost him. So bronze medal position for him at that point, but plenty of room for the rest to get past him. But for Vjoga, very competitive time. And at 1:52.19, held the gold medal position, but real class still to come. Class in the form of this man. This was the final heat of 12. Stephen Hartman of the USA in the blue and white suit on the inside, but in the dark blue and silver with the red flashes, the distinctive Austrian ski suit, this time occupied by Linus Heidegger of Austria, looking to get past that lead time. Just so you don't get confused, the splits that are coming up against the gold medalist Konrad Nagy. We'll see Konrad skate in just a moment. Really worth another watch, because it's superb. Take the gold medal for Hungary. So this was about Austria trying to get in amongst the medals, trying to attack that lead time. But more than anything else, just try and get on to the podium. And to do that, the time to beat was 1:52.56. Here, the Austrian coach getting very vocal with his skater. Real endeavour from the Austrian. You can see the determination in his face down that straight line of Seidiger, trying to push very hard with the 400 metres bell sounding, the last lap to go. Austrian coach with the board, just letting him know how far off the pace he is and how much work he's got to do. And he tried very, very hard. Steve Hartman at this point was out of it for the USA. Heidegger just drifting a little wide off that last bend, but I'm not sure that that would have done it for him. But a very, very good time into silver medal position at 1:52.07. So very, very close. Just 1,200ths faster than Vjorgat. But the man in the green and dark blue, Konrad Nagy of Hungary, is the man that turned in the performance of the evening. in the 1500 metre race here at this World University Speed Skating Championships in Bazalgette de Pinic. Nagy very, very powerfully away. Brilliant skate from him. And incidentally, well worth to mention that the fastest time set at this track in 1500 metres is by the American speed skater Shani Davis in the Ascent ISU World Cup back in 2008. Set a time at 1:46.85, which is very, very quick around this outside track. And while Nagy wasn't quite in that category, he wasn't far off. So brilliant start from him, came through the halfway point with a handy advantage. 1.33 seconds in hand. But we saw a few athletes tie up in the last 400 and waiting to see if Nagy was in the kind of form where he could keep that drive going all the way to the line, and pretty soon that became evident as the bell sounded. Kloszynski, incidentally, Polish racer in the red suit in this heat with him, and he wasn't far off the pace at this point, but Kloszynski did tie up. This is where it really started to hurt from him with the switch to the outside lane. Nagy though dropping in to the inside lane for the tighter bend ahead of the finishing straight. And watch Nagy come off of this. Very, very good work from him, driving as early as he could and then pushing very hard for the line to beat that lead time of Jugat. 1:51.22, the winning time in the end. Men's team pursuit then will be our final event on the track this evening from this World University Speed Skating Championships here in Northern Italy at Bazalgette de Pinic. And it's Netherlands against Poland, first out onto the ice. So we've got Ronald Marinus Luchtenberg, then we've got Bart Vreugdenhil. We've seen him in action already in the 1500. Alma Visser and Olaf Gerritsen. You can have four athletes in your team, but it's the first three across the line. For Poland, starting on the crossing straight of the bend, whereas the finishing straight on this near side for the Netherlands. You'll see them both come up in vision as they go round, hopefully. Marcin Bacinek, Sebastian Kluczynski, Adrian Wjogat and Mikhail Ostrzejewski. And Poland, with that kind of lineup, must be looking at a medal here, surely. As we come through, the red suits comfortably in the lead. That's a very fast lap at 32 seconds. Hunting in a pack. It's the time taken, the clock stops when your last man comes across the line, your last man of three. Those armbands signifying the various colours, white, red, yellow, blue, for the four men that can potentially skate. Poland ramping this up. Look at that, 28 seconds. Moving through the gears here. Poland are going to set a very fast time indeed. ...1:14.86 at that last split. Keep an eye on that as we move through the next two heats. Look at the difference between the red suits on the far side of the track and the orange suits on the near side of the track. Poland just drifting a little bit out to 29.2. The Netherlands are not far off in terms of the speed, so the athletes just starting to tie up a little bit here. No changes of lane. It's all about the inside line, keeping as close to those bends as you possibly can and shortening the distance. Well, the clocks will catch up hopefully any second now as Poland cross the line. Four laps to go at 1:59.72, and Poland are going to have to be careful here because the Netherlands, I don't think, are done and dusted just yet. A little bit of canny skating from the man with the white armband on there. Marcin Bacinek at the back having to be very careful. this is where you've got to make sure that one of your guys doesn't tie up and struggle. All three across the line, remember, three laps to go. Poland have stuck their faster laps in. Now it's about hanging on. Poland still lead. Netherlands and about 4 seconds off the pace being set by the Polish. ...800 meters to go, just over the 3 minute mark for Poland, and managing to set a very similar pace to the Netherlands, so that means the Netherlands will not be able to take too much out of the clock here on the Polish. Oh, it's not a bad rhythm, is it? That's looking good from the Polish team. Good tight formation as they move towards the bell. ...331.36 from Poland. One last push. Final 400 metres for both teams in this pursuit. And it's going to be Poland to post the fastest time. Bacinek still having to be very careful at the back there and just drive his other teammates on. Poland then looking for the time to set the mark in this championship. It's all trying to get level across the line, and 4:03.05 is the lead time for Poland. 4:07.55, that's a possible medal shot for the Netherlands, but that's a fine skate. Poland with no gold medal this evening so far from their athletes' endeavours. We'll have to wait and see. Belarus, Italy go in the next heat. Russia, USA go in the final heat. Good formation, good discipline, and really good work from Poland across those last few metres. That's when you can lose your form, that's when you can lose athletes at the back. And that's a satisfying sight. As the guys were driving for the line, they would have noticed the Dutch trio in their sights. So not for Netherlands in that first heat. 4:07.55 then. Poland set the first mark of the evening in the men's pursuit. Men's pursuit here at the World University Speed Skating Championships on Eurosport. Belarus in the next heat, only fielding the three men, Gleb Astapatu, and the man that we saw go in the 1500 metres, Maxim Kandrasel, and Anton Kapustin, both men going in the 1500 for Belarus, but not quite able to get on the podium. For Italy, David Giotto held the lead for a while in the 1500. Riccardo Bigardi, Alessio Trentini also had the lead briefly, and Mirko Giacomanenzi. Disappointing evening for Mirko. They're just looking to see if he's actually started this one. Looking for a blue armband for Mirko. Is it there? I can't see. The third Italian athlete doesn't have an armband on. So into the race. Three athletes, remember, pursuit race as they move round the track. It's all about getting your three men across the line to stop the clock. Eight laps of skating. And the early pace from both teams nowhere near as fast as Poland and the Netherlands. So these guys work into their own plan. Got a balletic rhythm there from the Belarus trio. More endeavour from the Italians, sharing the pace setting. At the moment though, it's the yellow bib of Kapustin that's pace setting for Belarus. Belarus are setting the pace, but 7 seconds off that lead time set by Poland in terms of the split, with five to go. There's that little switch around. Italy are flying and closing down the gap on Belarus. In fact, making it very, very difficult here for the TV director to give us an accurate view of what's going on, because Italy are eating the ice away at the moment from Belarus. Belarus not really doing much in this race at all. 9 seconds off the pace. Italy, 4.5 seconds under the pace. And this is what the pursuit's all about. Pursue and catch your opponents, but once you've caught them, there's work to be done still. And Belarus here are going to get absolutely roasted with quite a way to go. They've got to make way for the Italians down this straight. Fantastic slipstreaming from the Italian trio, and they fan out to make sure that the passing manoeuvre is completed. Now then, just keep an eye on the clock. Belarus out of this now. It's all about Italy versus the clock, which boils down to Italy versus Poland's 4:03.05, and they've still got 4.5 seconds in hand. Nenzi looks like he's taken over the pace setting, just getting a little nudge from the man behind him. In fact, it was Nenzi in behind him. Giotto, no, my apologies, that's Giotto with the white armband on, the tallest of the Italian athletes. So Giotto takes over the pace. And just behind in the yellow, Trentini. Italy improving their lot. Now this is where Poland started to fade, started to drift out to 32 second laps in the closing stages. Giotto determined that that's not going to happen. And Giotto is pushing his men very hard here. Just that little bit of separation between the lead Italian. It's not about the first man across the line, it's about the third man across the line. And a little stumble there from the yellow bib of Trentini, and Trentini really was tying up towards the end. But they've got it across the line in gold medal position. That will absolutely delight the fans here. And it will delight that man, Enrico Fabri, the mentor and coach for this university team, multiple Olympic and Universiade medalist in his own right, will be very, very pleased with that. 3:57.81 for the Italians. That is a cracking time. Left nothing on the ice, did they? Italy move into gold medal position with just two teams to pressure them. Russia alongside USA next out. Well, Russia have got some quality in there in Melnikov and Gorshkov, but Saludkin, I'm sure, will come out with them, or will it be Zolotarev? But either of those men is going to have to work very, very hard to stay with the lead guys. It's looking very good for Italy on home ice with our final event of the evening from this World University Speed Skating Championships in Bazzaglia di Pini in northern Italy. The men's team pursuit, and what a time the Italians have posted. Poland were leading 4:03.05, but Italy come back hard. 3:57.81, the gold medal time at the moment. Now, Russia have quality in Melnikov and Gorshkov. But Saludkin and Zolotarev, two men that are untested, really, at this pace. Saludkin faded in his 1,500 metres earlier today. Well, just looking at the armbands out there, it does look like Saludkin has started with Melnikov and Gorshkov. So keep an eye on the man with the red armband in the middle there. He's going to be protected as this race goes on, Saludkin, and that's the man they've got to skate to. supposed to be out there against Team USA. I'm afraid Hartman, Turner, Koenig and Goodwin not fielded a team for the USA. That's a shame, because they too have a little bit of quality as well. Italy lead then in gold medal position, Poland in silver medal position, Netherlands on 407.55 in bronze medal position. So they will be keeping an eye on this Russian performance. They will be keeping an eye on the performance of Ivan Solodkin. Look back through my notes, and Solodkin of Russia went against Riccardo Borghari of Italy in the first race of this evening in the 1500. And that little bit of communication there between the Russian athletes, sure. Can't translate accurately for you, but I'm sure that must have been along the lines of a communication with Solodkin to just check how he was feeling. Yeah, 156.04 was his time earlier, so he didn't disgrace himself in the 1500 metres by any means, but he's not quite in the same category as Melnikov and Gorshkov on their day. So this is going to be a tricky piece of time management here for this Russian team. I think 357.81 is going to be beyond them. I'd say at the moment, on the pace they're setting, 403.05 for silver and Poland's time is going to be beyond them. Yes, drifting all the time on the clock. Italy, I think, can just about start their gold medal celebrations here. They are going to pick up a medal on the first day of these championships in the men's team pursuit. And that armband, that yellow armband there of Gorshkov, is teetering on his wrist. He's going to have to watch that doesn't fly off and cause a problem. Just what you don't need. Still talking, still communicating. I think they're skating for bronze here, this Russian team. Again, it's how long Solodkin can stay with it. It should be Solodkin in the red armband. He's at the back at the moment. Keep an eye on him. Melnikov, I have to say, also faded a little bit in his 1500. So there's a couple of questions here over the Russian trio. Them against the clock, and the bell goes for the final lap. 6.7 seconds off the pace puts them in bronze medal position, just ahead of the Netherlands. But I thought the Netherlands pushed really hard towards the end of the race. That's exactly what the Russians are going to have to do here. Last man across the line, remember, is where the clock stops. They are keeping the three together. But this is a very tired trio as they push hard for the line, driving towards it and get across it in 406.61 for bronze. Netherlands' time of 407.55 surpassed, and Russia make the podium. And that was mighty hard work. Wow. Well, good to see that sort of endeavour. That none of the Russian armbands fitting. All of them slipping down the arm and nearly causing a problem. But that was the least of their worries. It was all about keeping the trio together and getting all three across the line inside the Dutch time for a bronze. And they did it. Finally, Solodkin's red armband gives up the ghost and flies off down the track, but no problems for him. I thought he might be the weak link, but he held his own very well there. And that's a beautifully timed piece of work. Confirmation then, the gold medal goes to Italy. They have opened their account at this championships. Poland pick up a third medal of the evening, but still no gold for them. And Russia claim bronze just ahead of the Netherlands and Belarus. So Italy keeping the home fans happy here at this World Speed Skating University Championships with a gold medal on day one. Well, that's it for our coverage from the World University Speed Skating Championships for the moment. For this evening, Italy taking a gold medal to finish things off in the men's team pursuit. Japan through Takahashi taking a very nice silver and bronze, and a gold medal also going to Hungary with Nagy. That was a gold, incidentally, for Takahashi in the women's 3,000, 1,500 metres. Nagy taking a gold. So three different nations winning the gold on our first day of coverage here from Baselga di Pine. We'll see you again with more coverage from this championships at the weekend. But for now, goodbye.
University Championships. FISU, today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.